a good example, if you put me down the last hole and say there was water down the left and rough down the right, there's a pretty good chance on a normal day I will hit it in the rough.
Portuguese Masters.
Well, I had a two-shot lead, so I'm definitely hitting it in the rough. But if I'm just saying on a Thursday, I'll probably hit in the rough because it's kind of the safe play. Mm-hmm. But on a Sunday, with needing to make birdie or par down the last, but certainly birdie, I will try and hit it down. I will hit it in that water. And this is a failing of mine a little bit. I'll hit it in the water before I hit it in the right-hand rough.
Because you feel it's the brave thing to take on.
I've got to go for it. And if I hit it in the water, as bad as hitting it in the water and people will go, I will walk off and go, yeah, I know I was going for it. Now, I have to be careful because you don't want the attitude of hit in the water and look good, because the biggest choker you see in golf, and the commentators play into this so much, you see the guy with a 15-footer to tie on the last hole and he hits it 3 feet by and the commentators will say, he gave it a go.
Yeah.
But he choked. He hit it 3 feet by on the pace that he was trying to hit a foot by. He was trying not to be embarrassed.
Okay.
So hitting in the water, I've got to make sure that's not the goal either, trying to be brave. The brave is hit it on the fairway and not worry about hitting in the water, which I'm better able to do. As the guy said, like you mentioned earlier, some of it is perception. But the lads, Shane and Dermo, his caddy, played with me in Turkey and they talked about it afterwards. I played quite a bit of golf with the lads, but they'd never seen me like that, where I was actually in contention and just like
going for it,
buzzed to the high heaven, and just so much. I have fear, but just I don't care. I don't. It's a fear. I don't.
Would you care if you hadn't won three majors? If you hadn't won a tournament, you'd be.
I think that's why I won the three majors. I'd learned that. By those 29 second places over the years, I'd learned that, you know what, being in contention and falling on your face is not a bad place to be.
And the world doesn't end.
I'm not going to be embarrassed by that.
Okay.
That's basically what I'm saying. I'm not embarrassed by messing up down the last, and I just relish the opportunity to have it.
Were you embarrassed at any point in your 29 seconds? The first 10 times, are you embarrassed?
No. The only time I was ever embarrassed on the golf course was on the 72nd hole at Carnoustie.
Yeah.
When I hit the first shot, and I was very much in that attitude. Anybody can hit a bad shot. It's not over. Let's do it. We're still okay. When I hit the second shot, it's the first time. Yeah. And it's the first time that not just my family and not fans, but the ones who genuinely, you know, were there. It's the first time I ever felt like I let anybody down. I was devastated that I actually have choked. And, I ultimately, that's what it was.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot goes on and I dropped the ball in the wrong place for the second shot. You know
the way you talked about if you're 30 yards ahead of the guy that you're playing with off the tee and you chest out alpha male, if embarrassment does anything to us, it crumples us a bit.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
So you did well actually to even get, I got to get my physiology back here? Did you think of that stuff?
This is the first time in my life I've been embarrassed on the golf course. I've hit a dreadful second shot and I feel like it's all gone. And, you know, if somebody could have come in and if they could have subbed me off, thank you very much. I would have been out there.
Yeah.
And I'd worked with my caddy Ronan and I told this story for six months afterwards. And Ronan started into the cliches. We'd worked on this, so he says it's not over yet. One shot at a time. I wanted to kill him.
Sure.
I was not, you know, I think he had to take the club off me, a 4-iron, because I would have hit him. I was devastated. Mm-hmm. So for 50 yards he just bombarded me, and then the next 50 yards, you know, I started to listen and I only hit it 150 yards. So the last 50 yards, I actually believed. And it's a very rare situation where you go from being in the zone, out of the zone, and I was back in the zone. And I hit that chip shot on the 72nd hole. And just this chip shot, I hit it like a teenager showing off.
It's a bit of fizz on it.
Fizzed it in there. But just like a kid when they're out practicing, fizz it in there. Everybody thinks it's going over the green and I'm going, it's going to spin. Like a child. Now, I didn't get that experience on the putt, but on the chip, I was so much in the zone.
I think Dermot has said that's the most impressive thing he's ever seen, was the way you got that back together again.
Well,
I tell
the story, as I said, McCaddy.
We all wanted to run out of the gate.
Oh, yeah. But that's the point. Yeah. Like, as I said, people at home tell me they turned the TV off and didn't know I won. People broke their TV. They're the people I was dying with. And I was the... McCaddy, he went through it. Ronan was like, it's not over. And all the cliches.
Mm.
And they can only be cliches, by the way. This is it. But when I tell the stories afterwards, and I says, and you know, my caddy, he believed. And he looks at me and says, no, I thought you lost the effing open as well. You know, which is,
yeah.
You know, but I suppose that's the, you know, and the great thing for me is I can, my caddy won me a major. Everybody always asks, well, can the caddy do anything? The caddy, it's what he says and what he doesn't say is, on some days, it's just incredibly important. He did his job, didn't hang his head, and a lot of caddies would have accepted my, he would have seen my devastation, and the two of us would have put the head down, slumped our way up there,
yeah,
finished out.
Accept your fate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
he didn't.
Well, yeah, he did, you know, the beauty is he did his job. It wasn't that he didn't accept the fate. He was like, both of us were accepting our fate, but we, thankfully, he just continued and didn't let on.
Hmm.
See, he lied too. Now, now
it's and he swore.
He did swear afterwards. Effing.
So it's okay in some circumstances.
Yeah, but not in print for sensational reasons. Yeah.